and I securely delete everything except the operating system. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question I get actually from time to time. I'm about to give away my machine, but I want to leave Windows installed. How can I securely delete everything except the operating system? You can't. No, not really, not completely, and definitely not securely. I'm going to describe a few steps that will delete a lot, perhaps enough for your concerns, but it really depends on how paranoid you are about the various traces that could still be left on a machine you've been using for a while. Deleting everything? Well, there's really only one way to do that. The process starts by, well, deleting and uninstalling as much as you can. Delete your data files, uninstall all the programs you've used or added and you don't want to be part of that machine when it's reused by someone else. For your data files, that means deleting things from My Documents or wherever else you happen to have kept data files. A good start for programs is to take a walk through add or remove programs or programs and features or apps or whatever they're calling it this week in Control Panel or the Settings app and just start uninstalling. For extra security, you might want to use Revo Uninstaller instead. Revo not only lists a few more things, but it uninstalls more thoroughly. It uses a couple of levels of aggressiveness to determine what to remove, and this is one case where it makes sense to be as thorough as possible. If your machine has more than one user account, remove all except for a single account that has administrator privileges. This should actually delete a bunch of files associated with those other accounts. Run the built-in disk cleanup utility, or grab a copy of CCleaner, a free download, you do not need to buy their support, and use it to clean up as much as it can. The goal here is to remove traces from browser caches, temporary files, and a host of other things, many of which might very well be benign, but many others that may inadvertently contain things you'd rather not share with your machine's subsequent owners. Consider running a registry scan. Now, it's clear, I'm not a big fan of registry cleaners, but this is a case where they might remove additional stuff you don't want left behind, and the cost of failure, an unbootable machine, is relatively low. You might want to take an image backup prior to the cleaning in case you want to recover from that worst-case scenario. Turning off some system files is also an interesting thing that I don't see a lot of people mention. Set your virtual memory to zero and delete the paging files. Turn off hibernation and remove the hibernation file. These are hidden files in the root of your system drive, typically C colon. Turn off system restore. All of these files could actually contain private information and can be turned back on if wanted by the machine's new owner. Using a tool then like CCleaner's Drive Wiper, securely erase all the unused space on your hard disk. As we know, merely deleting files doesn't overwrite the data, so it could still be recovered. Tools like Drive Wiper actually overwrite all of the unused space on your hard drive with random data to completely remove all traces of what had been there before. That's about as good as you can get using this approach. The problem with the approach is that you don't know what you might have missed. Even after all that deleting and cleaning, there might still be system files left showing something about who you are or what you used the machine for. For example, very easily there could be registry settings that remain contain settings for programs, even for programs that aren't installed anymore. You just don't know. That's why I don't recommend anything I've just told you. Nuke it instead. Boot from the Windows installation media, which you can get as a download from Microsoft if you don't already have it, and install Windows from scratch, making sure, as part of that process, to erase the hard disk. Erasing the hard disk completely is the only way to be absolutely certain you haven't left personal information on the machine prior to handing it off to someone else. So, bottom line, if at all possible, nuke it. That way, you're certain not to have left anything sensitive behind. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/4716. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.